தோழர்களே, நண்பர்களே, வணக்கம். மன்னிக்கணும், நான் ஆங்கிலத்தில் பேச போகிறேன். லீடர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி ப்ரோக்ரெசிவ் செக்குலர் ப்ரோக்ரெசிவ் அலையன்ஸ் ஆன் த டயஸ், ஐ எம் நாட் நேமிங் ஆல் தி லீடர்ஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் லேக் ஆஃப் டைம். அண்ட் டியர் பிரதர்ஸ் அண்ட் சிஸ்டர்ஸ், தி 17th லோக் சபா எலெக்ஷன் has begun and Tamil Nadu will go to the polls on the 18th of this month, just 3 days away. This election is going to be the most crucial in the history of independent India, because the ruling party, the Bharatiya Janata Party, and its controlling organization, the RSS, do not believe in the Constitution of India. Today is the birth anniversary of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, who was the architect of the Constitution. And we must recall the words of Dr. Ambedkar after the Constitution was adopted. Dr. Ambedkar said, however good a constitution, if the people working the constitution are bad, then the result will be bad. Today, the people who are entrusted with the responsibility of implementing this constitution are the very people who want to subvert the constitution. That is the danger today. So this election is going to be crucial, because those who believe in this constitution, those who believe in secularism and democracy, the principles enshrined in the constitution, they have to come together to defeat the Bharatiya Janata Party and remove the Modi government from power. During the last 5 years of the BJP's rule, time and again BJP members of parliament and even ministers in the union cabinet have made statements that the constitution has to be changed. One of the ministers, Anant Kumar Hegde from Karnataka, he's a minister in the union cabinet, he has gone on record saying, we want to change this constitution, we cannot have this constitution. Why do they say so? Because the RSS has never accepted this constitution. In 1950, when this constitution was adopted, the RSS said that this is not a constitution suitable for our Indian society and culture. We must have a constitution based on Manusmriti, the values of Manusmriti. So this is the type of ruling party and ideology which is posing a serious threat to our secularism and democracy and our constitution. During the last 5 years, we have seen in North India and in Western India how the BJP and the RSS have sought to divide people on religious lines, how they have sought to create communal tensions and polarization, how the minorities have been targeted. 47 people, innocent people, were killed by mob lynchings in the name of cow slaughter. The 47th victim was just killed day before yesterday in Jharkhand, where there's a BJP state government. So under this Modi rule, we have seen all the constitutional principles that all citizens are equal, that everyone has equal opportunities. All this has been given the go by the BJP and RSS's Hindutva ideology. In this election campaign, we can see the desperation of the BJP leaders, including Narendra Modi. They are making speeches to rouse communal feelings. They are trying to rouse feelings that Hindus are being in danger. They are trying to pose as if they are the only party and government which can protect the country from external and internal enemies. They are trying to create fear and insecurity among the people. That is because they have nothing to show, nothing positive to show for their five-year rule. Because all the promises they made to the people in the last Lok Sabha elections have proved to be hollow and false. It is the BJP and Narendra Modi who promised that they will create 2 crore jobs every year when they form the government. And in 5 years, 10 crore jobs for our youth will be created. But what is the record? Instead of creating employment, they have created unemployment. According to the government's own statistics, which they have suppressed now, the rate of unemployment in our country is at the highest level in the last 45 years. Last year, in 2018 alone, 1 crore, 1 lakh jobs were lost or destroyed. Of these, 88 lakhs were jobs of women, women's employment that has been finished. So this is the record as far as employment is concerned. This is not some figure or statistic in abstract. You all know from your own experience how jobs have been lost in the last 2-3 years. Here in Coimbatore itself is a best example of that, where thousands of jobs have been lost because of the closure of small and medium enterprises, because of the Modi's demonetization of 500 and 1,000 rupee notes, followed by the imposition of the GST. You have seen large-scale closure of so many small, medium and micro enterprises, which has thrown so many people out of their jobs and livelihood. So this is the reality. Here is a government which has launched a serious assault on the livelihood of the people. The other major failure of this government is its promise to tackle the agrarian crisis of providing farmers with a decent price and livelihood. I don't want to go into all those details, but in the BJP's election manifesto, they promised to give farmers cost of production plus 50% as the minimum support price for their produce. But nowhere has this been implemented. And farmers steeped in debt have committed suicide in their thousands in different parts of the country. Now, before the elections, the Modi government announced that they'll give 6,000 rupees per family, farmer's family, per year, which means not even 17 rupees a day. What is the use of such a paltry amount for the farmers? This itself is an admission of their abject failure to fulfill their commitment to the farmers. It is the claim of Narendra Modi, time and again, that he has provided a corruption-free government. He says there's not even a single instance of corruption under his regime. But now, every day, more and more exposures are coming of one of the biggest corruption scandals, which is the Rafael jet purchase scandal. How Narendra Modi himself intervened to change the agreement and to get contracts for his favorite capitalist, Anil Ambani. All those details are now coming out. How the French government was compelled to accept Anil Ambani as a partner. And now 30,000 crores worth of contracts are now being given to a company which has no experience whatsoever in defense production. So on all fronts, the Modi government has failed, except in one area, which is to divide the people, to try to create communal tensions and to target the minorities and to damage and destroy the secular basis of our system. We have seen how the BJP and the Modi government have sought to implement the fascistic slogan of the RSS, which is one language, one culture, one religion and one leader. We have seen how they have tried to impose Hindi and Sanskrit on all sections of the people in all states, including Tamil Nadu. We have seen how they have tried to ensure that the rights of the states are curtailed and to have a complete, a centralized authoritarian rule. And of course, they are trying to project that there can be only one leader, Narendra Modi, for this country. So, the interests of the people of Tamil Nadu, the interests of Tamil Nadu itself has been threatened by the BJP rule at the center. It is at this juncture that the AIADMK government here, the Edappadi government here, has completely surrendered to the BJP. It has forged an alliance with a party which I said is inimical to the interests of Tamil Nadu and the Tamil people. And this alliance is what we have to ensure its defeat in the coming elections. There is no instance where the state government took a stand to protect and defend the interests of Tamil Nadu and its people. When demonetization was imposed on this country, they did not protest. When all this damage was done, unlike in Kerala, where the LDF government, the chief minister and the entire cabinet sat on dharna outside the Reserve Bank of India in Trivandrum to protest against how the demonetization is harming the people's interests. So in every instance here in Tamil Nadu, the AIADMK government has proved to be a slave of the BJP government at the center. That is why in this Lok Sabha election, we have to ensure the defeat of the AIADMK-BJP alliance here. Along with that, in the assembly by-elections which are taking place, 18 and then 4 more, we have to ensure the defeat of the AIADMK so that both in Tamil Nadu and in the Lok Sabha level, we will be able to defeat the BJP and the BJP-AIADMK alliance here. So in this election, this secular progressive alliance led by the DMK should be able to achieve a victory in all the 40 seats here in Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. And in here in Kovai, this is one of the seats. I think there are 5 seats the BJP is contesting. This is one of the seats where there is going to be a direct contest between this alliance and the BJP. And we have to ensure the defeat of the BJP in this Kovai constituency. We have seen how communal forces have sought to create problems and divide the people in Coimbatore in the past. If the BJP is able to win this seat, it would mean giving a fillip to all the communal forces here, giving an encouragement to the extremist forces which earlier also have reared their heads in Coimbatore. So that is why it is very important that the Secular Progressive Alliance candidate, Comrade P.R. Natarajan, who has a proven track record earlier as a member of parliament from here, you should be able to mobilize people, ensure the widest support so that he wins with a big majority in Kovai when you go to the polls on the 18th of April. I appeal to you to put all your efforts into this, and I thank you for giving me a patient hearing, and I convey my warm greetings once more to you.